Good afternoon, everyone. Today, Group B is presenting a paper. The name of the paper is Impact of Single versus Double Layer Closure on Adverse Outcomes and Uterine Scar Defect, a Systemic Review and Meta-Analysis. First, let me give you a brief introduction of uterine closure in cesarean section. It is an important step in immediate post-operative period and also future gestations. There is increasing evidence to suggest that surgical technique for uterine closure affects uterine scar healing. Abnormal uterine scar healing is thought to be associated with risk of placenta accreta and uterine rupture in future pregnancies. The optimal uterine closure technique is undetermined. In this paper, a systemic review and meta-analysis is conducted to evaluate the effect of type of uterine closure on uterine scar and adverse maternal outcomes. Usually, uterine closure involves the following steps. First, the angle of uterine incision is grasped using Allis forceps to stabilize and maneuver incision. The initial suture is placed just beyond the angle of uterine incision. A continuous suture is usually performed, and each suture penetrating full thickness of myometrium. And it continues just beyond opposite angle of uterine incision. If approximation or hemostasis is unsatisfactory, the clinician will consider another layer of continuous suture, or figure of 8 matrix suture for individual bleeders. The serosal edges overlying uterus and bladder is typically not approximated. There are some important considerations in uterine closure. The first layer of uterine closure is always performed, while continuous suture is associated with shorter operative time and lower blood loss as compared to interrupted suture. Locking of primary layer of closure facilitates hemostasis but may compromise healing and impair the microcirculation around the wound. So in this paper, randomized control trials compare number of layers, single versus double, and the use of locking versus unlocking sutures for uterus closure in low transverse cesarean is studied. The keyword medical subject heading search is performed in PubMed, Web of Science, InBase, and Cochrane Central Register, and try to identify papers from 1980 to September 2013. The quality of these studies were evaluated by Cochrane Handbook criteria for judging risk of bias. The sensitivity analysis for studies with high risk of bias and quality and integrity of review is also evaluated. The paper includes several maternal outcomes, which includes infection, endometritis, wound infection, blood transfusion, mean blood loss, duration of surgical procedure, and length of hospital stay. And the long-term adverse outcome include uterine rupture or dishancence. Post-cesarean ultrasonographic evaluation of uterine scar includes the presence of uterine scar defect and residual myometrial thickness in millimeters. Risk ratios with 95% CI is compared binary outcomes is carried out between the two closure types, and so was the main difference with 95% CI compared continuous outcomes. The I2 criteria of Higgins et al. Paper is used to assess heterogeneity between studies. In the sensitivity analysis, testing robustness of the findings, and to explain heterogeneity between studies, comparing suture type, thread type, region, and primary cesarean. So here are some of the results. First, about 176 trials are identified for further evaluation, and about 40 is identified for further review. Studies included in this analysis is 20. The comparison between single and double layer closure, the two maternal outcomes are significant, which includes the duration of the cesarean and hospital stay. There's no difference identified for maternal infectious morbidity, endometritis, lung infection, blood transfusion, and mean blood loss. And the residual myometrium thickness, single layer suture is found to be associated with lower residual myometrium thickness. Two randomized trials was identified comparing locked versus unlocked sutures. In the first one, there is no difference in the risk of uterine scar distances at next cesarean delivery for double layer suture with the first layer locked compared to double layer suture with unlocked first layer. But decreased myometrium thickness and increased blood loss is associated with locking of the first layer. For the second trial, there is no difference in terms of proportions of scar defect at ultrasound 6 to 12 months after cesarean using continuous locked single layer compared to interrupted unlocked single layer suture. But continuous locked single layer closure was coupled with a larger scar defect on sonographic evaluation. Here are some of the conclusions. First, there is no difference in terms of the risk of maternal morbidity or long-term outcomes between single versus double-layer uterus closure at low transverse cesarean. Data from randomized trials are insufficient to conclude about the risk of uterine rupture, dissensus, or gynecological outcomes because of insufficient power. Single layer closure was associated with decreased residual myometrial thickness and shorter operative time. Few data are available on the impact of locked versus unlocked suture that favor the use of unlocked sutures to obtain a thicker myometrium measured by ultrasound. So, generally the conclusion is that more studies need to be conducted to determine the optimal techniques and sutures need for lower segment cesarean section. That's it. Thank you very much.